Hey, it's Fromance96 here with Saints Row 2. One of the pretty much favorite games that I've been waiting for a really long time. Went out, got it, pre-ordered it like 3 months ago. And I've already beaten the game. Took me like four and a half days it took me to beat this game. The gangs are pretty cool. I'll go to the continue game, but yeah, I've gotten the game already beaten through. I think the gangs are pretty cool. They're better than the ones in Saints Row 1, because Saints Row 1, like, they didn't have that good of a storyline. And, like, in this game, the storyline is, like, a lot better to me. I really like it. The character is the leader of the gang now. This is what my guy looks like. He's got the cool sunglasses, the whole suit thing going on. And he's got the mohawk. I had the pimp hat on for a little while, and then like kind of looked weird, so I took it off. But yeah, I got this. These are the Cobras. I have infinite ammo for them. You have to do this activity. I forget what it's called, what activity it was. You beat all the way through, you get these. But let's get on with the game. The game overall is really good. I think it's better than Grand Theft 4 and it's better than Mercenaries 2. But the thing is, it's pretty much a combination of both of those. There you go, take that out. What? And because Saints Row, it kind of like reminds me of Mercenaries 2, because like you can do a bunch of things. And then, you know, pretty much you can take people, use them as shields, and just be like fighting someone like this. Like, oh yeah, you want to fight me? And then you gotta get rid of them, just throw them, because I'll be again. It's pretty cool. And you just revive your homie like Saints Row 1. Pretty much if you make your guy, and then you make them mad wherever they attack. Okay, pretty much my rating on this game, and pretty much a lot of ratings. This rating, the game, it's 8.7 out of 10. Because, I mean, it's really good. But the graphics are just a little teensy bit better than Saints Row 1. I mean, they didn't put that much time into it. They could have put more into it, though. But the game's pretty cool. You can ride bikes now, which is awesome, which I'm doing right now. Pretty much just like Grand Theft 4, this game is. Pretty much the music is really cool. I like all the music. I like the cover system. I like the guns. They've added new guns. You can do a bunch of stuff. You got the chainsaw now, which is really cool. I'm gonna use the chainsaw. I'll show you how the chainsaw looks when you kill someone. It's really like cool. Just like go up on them, just cut them in half, pretty much. But it doesn't like, it's not that gory. This game's pretty gory. It's like Texas Chainsaw Massacre. Just like run around and just like, oh yeah, you want mess with me? And just like, just chainsawing down, like, oh yeah, and then goodbye. And pretty much I like how your guy, how he acts, he's really like laid back, and pretty much you're unstoppable. Your team is really cool. You can customize your gang, customize your, you know what, screw this car, I'm gonna get that car right there. Customize your vehicles for your gang, like this. I made the Ferrari and all that, and it's really cool. I like the customizing of the gang, because you can make them bodyguards, 80s, you know, gangsters, all that. I pick bodyguard because, like, to me it looks really cool, because they're like pretty much, they're like the SWAT team, but they're like, they're a gang, so it's weird. It's like Ultor, like when you Ultor or whatever, I can't pronounce it right. Pretty much, they're like a gang, but not really, but they're like the SWAT team. It's kind of weird, but yeah. The game's really fun, actually. The cheats are pretty cool. In my last video, you saw all the cheats that I have. I have like all the cheats for like all the guns that like you can pick from anything. The flamethrower, the chainsaw, from any gun you can pretty much think of almost in this game. But I mean, there's a lot of guns that aren't in it. I mean, don't get me wrong with that. They have this new thing, like pretty much you can get stars for near misses oncoming lane, big air, a bunch of stuff. It's kind of cool. Kind of reminds me of Mercenaries. And then Grand Theft Auto 4, because it's got all the cars, the bikes. The storyline's really awesome. The graphics are really good. And to me, I think this game's better than Grand Theft Auto 4. Even though Grand Theft Auto 4 was like a really big hit. Even though pretty much it was like rated by most people like a 10 out of 10, 9 out of 10. And this game, for some reason, it got rated at the max 9 out of 10. But like the minimum is like 8.7 out of 10. Which is pretty much the rating I pick because they could have did better in this game. I like all the activities too, like they got Mayhem, they got pretty much, you can see I dominated this whole game. I got like all the places. They got a little island over here, and then they got another one over here. I got all the cribs. The cribs are really awesome. I'll go to the main crib and show you like how you can customize your, because it's the Saints hideout crib, you know? I'm like, let me see here, my phone. I like how the phone too, the phone's like Grand Theft Auto 4, but like to me it's a little bit better. I got all the homies, a stored vehicle delivery, I got that in the activity. Johnny Gat, you get as my homie. Legal Lee is a homie. Pierce is a homie. Shondi is a homie. Troy is a homie, and Toby's is a homie. And then, let's see, phone book, cheats, vehicles, the UFOs, the destroy cheat, the player ability, all this. And then you got the weapons, all the weapons and the flamethrower and everything. Weather, Wrath of God, which is all lightning, all this. Raining pedestrians, pedestrians, war, low gravity, evil cars. Evil cars is the one that I used in the last video. It's pretty cool. Side out here, it's like all crappy, but it's not like really the hideout. Okay. There's a bunch of strippers everywhere. Stripper poles. That was like a crappy statue until you like beat like two gangs pretty much. You get this statue. Looks really awesome actually. I like it. And you got the bodyguards everywhere, like the suits and everything. And then you got the stripper pole. And then you got the radio station right here. And you got all the beer, the stands, everybody sitting around. Okay, I would show you here. Customize your gang. See, style? I picked bodyguards, like I already told you. They got the 80s, which is like that. And then bodyguards. Gangster, looks pretty cool. Ninjas, I had that for a little while. And then like, after a while, I changed it because it got pretty dumb after a while to me. Because, like, I don't know, like, the ninja suit doesn't look that cool, actually, in this game. And Pimps and Hoes, I had that for a little while. It was kind of funny. Prep Hop, yeah, it's okay. It's not that cool, really. And then sporty, and I stick with bodyguards definitely because they look really awesome. Okay, the tag, you can change your tag, like you want that one, that one, that one. I had that one for a while. That one, I use that one, that one. I like this one for some reason because it's like the church from Saints Row 1, and I don't know, I just like it, pretty cool. And then the sign, you can be like, I can't hear you, son, and then like, I'm number one, and then middle finger and all that. I pick that, doesn't matter. And here's the vehicle slot that I was talking about. You got the Atrazone, you got the Baron, the Betsy, the Bezier, the Bootlegger, the Bulldog, the Capshaw, the Compton, the Cosmos, the Ethel, the Go, the Hailbird, the Hammerhead, the Hollywood Justice, Komodo, the Furiosa, Magma, Mockingbird, Nelson, Nordberg, Superior, Venom Classic, Vortex, Voyage, and Zimos. I pick with these three. I'll just keep it like that, but I think it's pretty cool. You can customize your gang, your cars. You can customize, like, everything. And then, like, out here, it's pretty much, like, dumb. Like, it's just, like, where all the bums, like, hang out. It's weird. And there's where I put the thing. And then, yeah, it's a pretty cool game. I like it a lot, and whatever I tell you, pretty much what I think, you should buy this game definitely, because if you like Saints Row 1, you're definitely gonna like this game. This game's 10 times better than the first one. Pretty much, yeah, and definitely buy it. Don't rent it. You rent it, you're gonna play it for a little while, and then you're gonna want more and more and more because you get addicted to pretty much the row, like in Saints Row 1, like you get that achievement for addicted to the row. You're definitely gonna get addicted to this game, so after a while, you're definitely going to want this game, so my choice is definitely buy this game. Don't rent it. And that was my review for Saints Row 2. And yeah, like I said, definitely go and buy this game. This game is really worth it. And if you don't want to buy it, rent it. But like I said, you're gonna regret it, because then you're just gonna be like, yeah, I pretty much wasted my money. I just went out and bought it. So yeah, I guess I'll see you guys later, and maybe I'll make a part 2 of this video, maybe. So I guess I'll see you guys later.